Hey everybody, I'm wrapping up Once Upon a September with my top 10 fairy tale books. Usually, picking favorites for me is impossible. I am notoriously indecisive, and I just can't make up my mind, mostly, because it changes so often. Sometimes my favorite is the funniest, and other times it's the most dramatic, or beautiful, or emotionally wrenching. So most of this list is approximately accurate as far as the favorite hierarchy goes. And this one is only currently true because there's still a ton of retold fairy tales out there that I haven't even read yet. As indecisive as I am, I have to admit, picking my all-time favorite fairy tale novel to date was a no-brainer. I know, it surprised me too! Number one is The Ever After series by Shelby Bach. It took me all of 10 seconds to realize that this series about a magical after-school program that prepares kids to relive their very own versions of fairy tales is in fact my number one favorite. This could just be because I'm currently obsessing over this series. You can tell that just from my reviews of them, but I think it's more than that. The Ever Afters is chock full of all of my favorite things. First off, it's middle grade fantasy, which is my favorite reading genre, plus it's retold fairy tales. The characters are wonderful. Their depth is, to be honest, quite astounding, and they're constantly developing. It's full of references for obscure fairy tales, the world is incredibly complex and believable, and the balance between the character's life as a normal teenage girl, albeit one with Hollywood star parents, and the character's life in the secret world of magic and quests is perfect and beautifully and intricately woven together. This book literally has everything. Humor abounds, but so does the action and drama, and the character interaction, and the real-life crises of fitting in and family problems, dealing with and solving issues with friends, the value and strength of friendship, realistic development for preteen characters, emotional struggles, and of course saving the world from an evil would-be conqueror. This is one of those rare series when I pick up the book, I don't know whether to read it all in a day and refuse to put it down or to savor it for as long as humanly possible. I am constantly blown away by the depth of this series. Number two is Enchanted by Alethea Contis. One of the things that really drew me into this book was not only the wonderful story, but the beautiful prose. Contis treats every sentence like a work of art, and this book is a virtual verbal museum. Number three is Wildwood Dancing by Juliet Marillier. Like Enchanted, this is a beautifully crafted story. But one of my favorite things is that Marillier chose not to set it against a fantastical background, like Enchanted, but instead, a historical one. I like to think of it as historical fantasy. You know, as opposed to historical fiction, it's set in 16th century Transylvania, and many of its fairy tale elements resound of local superstitions. It's really a unique treat in both the genre and the storytelling. Number four is The Hero's Guide to Saving Your Kingdom by Christopher Healy. This book speaks straight to my funny bone. A wisecracking narrator tells the tale of the princes collectively known as Prince Charming from various tales and their misfortune and bad luck that follows their rise in popularity thanks to the tales of Cinderella and Sleeping Beauty. It's an unconventional take on retellings told in an unconventional manner that reminds me of both Lemony Snicket and P.G. Wodehouse. That is not easy to do, ladies and gentlemen. Number five is Princess of the Midnight Ball by Jessica DeGeorge. Although it's been a few years since I've read this, this was impossible to put down. George seems to write this captivating and charming tale with ease, and I was immediately sucked in. What I love most is that it's mainly told from the perspective of the hero, Galen, and not the heroine or princess of the story. Number six is Cinder by Marissa Meyer. By far the most interesting version of Cinderella I've ever heard of, Cinder well deserves a place on my list for creativity and captivating storytelling. I wasn't sure she could pull off a cyborg Cinderella, but she can. Number seven, Ella Enchanted by Gail Carson Levine. This is one of the most beloved versions of Cinderella, and with good reason. Levine's fantasy world is beautifully and richly crafted, and the idea that Ella is cursed to be honest is such an interesting twist to the tale. It's not only a story about love and magic pumpkin carriages, but a wonderful coming-of-age tale of self-discovery and courage. Number eight is Rump, A Tale of Rumpelstiltskin by Liesl Shirtlift. This is another great coming-of-age tale about destiny, and whether you make one for yourself or you follow one that's been set down for you. What I love about this is the rich and sympathetic story Shirtlift weaves for one of the more notorious fairy tale characters, and how believably she pulls it off. Number 9 is the Sisters Grimm series by Michael Buckley. Mysteries and fairy tales were meant to be combined, but it was Michael Buckley who showed us that. My favorite part of the series is his unique spin on so many of the characters, including the Brothers Grimm, and how he condemned the fairy tale world to live in the real one, whether they wanted to or not. My favorite of his characters are Prince Charming, who, in an interesting twist, Buckley makes the same Prince Charming from every princess tale, and the Big Bad Wolf, for reasons which I won't reveal because they could be considered spoilers. Let's just say, I have a thing for reformed villains. Number 10 is another by Jessica Day George, Sun and Moon, Ice and Snow. Until this book, I had no idea there was a Norwegian folktale surprisingly close to Beauty and the Beast. The theme looks and sounds familiar, but George really expands on the Norwegian side of it, with trolls and fauns and lots of snow. Though still a retelling, this is a more obscure story, at least in my opinion, so this feels like a brand new fairy tale. I'd also like to include two honorable mentions, The Enchanted Forest Chronicles by Patricia C. Reedy and The Two Princesses of Bemari by Gail Carson Levine. Why, you ask, didn't these stories make the list? Because while they exhibit plenty of fairy tale ambiance and references, I cannot in good conscience classify these as retellings, considering that the main storyline of these books are completely original. However, they are amazingly wonderful books, and I couldn't pass up the chance to mention them. Chances are, if you like this genre or any of the books previously mentioned on my list, you are going to love these too. So, those are my top 10 favorite fairy tale books, and now it's my turn to ask, what are yours? Feel free to answer in the comments below, contribute a video response, or use the tag Favorite Fairy Tale Books. Thanks for watching, and hey, if you enjoyed this video, you know what to do.